So, hello everyone. We have new member, and this is Shakti, and I am recording this session with my friend. He's my friend from Kerala, and he's in Russia. So now he will talk about his journey, how he reached there, how he went to Russia. So, Shakti, please share your journey.
Hi Rahul. Hi friends. Share my journey means, see, I have been living in Russia since 2010. In between 2 years, I was in India. So almost I have completed 10 years here. I came here through my brother, one of my cousin brother. So he was working here before. It is a surprise for me also, because I never expected that I'll come to Russia. When I was working in India, once I met his wife. So she just simply asked me, Shakti, are you interested to go Russia? So I said, okay, of course, why not? It's a new country for me. So of course I like. And I just forgot that incident. And exactly 1 year later, he called up and said, there is an opportunity. So if you are interested, please send my passport and all. So I sent it. And somehow everything was fine. And I reached here.
Okay. So now, Shakti, see, because I'm recording this for, like, people should know why English is important and what are, like, see, your job. What is your job, actually?
I'm into sales. I'm a sales manager of Indian cosmetics. I'm working in an Indian cosmetic distribution company here.
Okay. So, like, how English impact your career? Like, because I feel that, in India, if you speak good English, people treat you as very intelligent person. But I know in Russia it is different because nobody speaks English. But still, I believe that before your communication, like when you are communicating to your clients, you are using English as a tool. So how it is like, how means how much English is important for you, for anybody's career? Like, suppose if it is not for you, like for anyone career, if you want to speak on that.
Rahul, as you said, it's really different in the scenario is very different in Russia, because when I reach here in Moscow, I have to say it's Moscow, the capital of Russia. English was literally zero here. We couldn't see even a signboard or a name of the shop, nothing in English. Everywhere it was written in Russian only. And the local peoples, they don't even know if I'm asking water, they are not understanding. So it was, the situation was like that. So when I was in India, I thought, oh, I can manage, because everybody was telling, even my teachers, my friends, and parents, everybody was telling, if you know English, you can survive anywhere in the world, because it's an international language. But it was really, that time I was remembering all these faces who told me that English is international language and you can survive with English if you know English. So that time, for water, if I'm telling water, they don't understand. If I'm, there's a joke actually. I think I have said it to you before also. One guy from India reached here in Moscow. And he actually want to buy chicken. So he went to a shop and he asked for chicken. So the shopkeeper was really struggling to understand what he needs. So he was searching to show the chicken. He was searching the shop, all the shop, but he couldn't find the chicken. And he just saw the eggs over there. And he was pointing the eggs and he was showing, mama. I need mama. Means, where is the mama? So, it means in Russian, gidi means where. And okay. Mama is mom. Gidya Mama, Gidya Mama, he was asking. And it was a funny moment. So it was like that. But the things changed after the 2018 World Cup.
Okay.
Because, when after World Cup, they realized that there is a huge chance in tourism here. So to attract the tourist people, they started slowly. They started the announcements in metros. Because before it was like announcement was only in Russian language, because a foreigner couldn't understand which is the stop, which is the next stop, nothing. Now they started announcement in English. They started a lot of signboards written in English.
Okay.
And people start learning English here, a lot of peoples. And they started, if before it was like that, if I start talking in English, they will stop me, and they will tell, see Shakti, you are in Russia, and if you want to live here, you should learn our language.
Yes.
We are not ready to learn some foreign language for you. So now the things have changed. Now they started asking me doubts
in English.
So the things is changing now. So let's hope, as my teachers and parents said, English.
The universal.
They will consider everybody will consider like.
Okay, English, so like, see, suppose now I want to like some. Suppose anybody want to learn English, and like there are two kind of people: those who have studied English, and those they. Means they didn't have any experience of learning English, like their books are in their local languages. So like how people should start, because I think the most like the most important part, you can write English, like if you read something then you can write, but the speaking requires a certain level of confidence. So like how you, what you will advise them how to start it, because now you are a part of
See, we can, in my aspect, learning a language is, there is two way.
Mm-hmm.
Either spoken,
mm-hmm.
that means you can communicate, but you are not going into the depth of that language.
Mm-hmm.
Because in Goa or in many tourist places, even in Kerala, I'm from Kerala. If you're going the Kovalam, maybe you might have heard of Kovalam. It's a very beautiful seashore. And every tourist are very attracted to them. So there are a lot of local peoples who are literally illiterate, but they speak English very nicely because it's their, they have to, it's their, because for surviving, for earning money, they have to communicate with the tourist.
Tourist, yes.
Then they never go to school or tuitions, nothing into the spoken English institution. They're not going anywhere, but they are struggling. They are for their earnings. They are somehow they are managing and they are learning.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure that they speak much better English than me.
Definitely.
But they are, they will be like, by grammatically, they might be zero. So spoken is actually, it's a really different learning a language. I can say learning a language is like it's very time taking process, the structure and all we have to learn. But spoken English or any other language, it's totally different. We can say anybody can with this kind of the experience or with the if you have some friends from different country, don't consider in English native, in any language, if you have some friends, normally you will start telling their language little by bit, and you will start understanding. So it happened. It's like that. So what I'm telling is you can, either you can learn the language very deeply with all the books and everything. Otherwise, you just make a friendship with some
thing
English
is you
guys
have to speak. Like first thing you have to decide, okay, you have to find a partner and you should speak. Whether you are speaking correctly or not, then you must speak.
Yeah.
Okay, so now your schooling, so what about your schooling? Like your schooling, from the schooling, you were a you were very good in English or you were an average student in terms of English, if you are, if somebody has to judge you?
See, maybe can tell a bit more than an average, not that much good, but okay. Not average, more than average.
So it like, see, like because you told me that your mother is an English teacher, and so
yeah, I think my mother gave me she gave me the base of English actually. She was so strict, and in my lower class itself, she was like she made the base. I can say she is my class teacher.
Okay. So now, suppose now, because you are the part of, you are a part of language artificial. So I want to ask you one thing, like things that, like suppose like the activity we are doing, and though I am not very like active nowadays, and but yes, I believe that these activities are very important for someone to learn. So I, what you got, like suppose if somebody wants to just speak in English, so these kind of groups are helpful or not?
Of course, it's really helpful. Yeah, of course, because if in the case of a beginner, mm-hmm. actually he is having the hesitation to speak in the public, mm-hmm. and because he might be much bothered about whether I am saying right or not.
Mm-hmm.
So it's this online group. It's really a good platform for such beginners, because they can speak without that hesitations, because he is sure that all the other guys are also in the same level,
mm-hmm.
so he can speak very fluently. Means without any hesitation he can start it. Okay. And it's a really appreciable thing that this kind of platform should come up.
Okay, so when I was discussing with Preeti, so initially when I was learning, like I'm I think 10 months back, so she told me that you have to first, the like you have, suppose you have 20 minutes for your English every day, like you have just only 20 mm-hmm. minutes. So now I will ask you the same things. Suppose you have 20 minutes in your day, then what you have to do? Listen, recording, reading, writing, or making video. So how you prioritize them? Like you have to choose only three, or you can choose only two: reading, recording, listening, writing.
I will suggest to listen.
I think listen first.
Write.
Listen and write.
Because listening.
What about speaking?
No, of course, speaking. And this read and recording. See, you gave me only two options. So,
okay.
Speaking,
so,
of course, needed. Yes. Because writing means it's an exercise that
grammatically
we can buy heart. We can grasp it very easily if you are writing. Mm-hmm. Because that's why the imposition, the teachers are giving us impositions.
Okay, so
if you are out of mind also, if you are writing, something will enter easily. And this reading, it depends. If you want to improve your pronunciation, then reading will help,
like
you.
Like vocabulary, also. Not pronunciation. I think vocabulary, okay. It is. Pronunciation will come.
Vocabulary. Yeah.
So
yes,
I think.
Sorry, I'm speaking. Yeah.
Yeah, speaking. So means first you should listen, then write. Mm. And I think the most important part is, whether you know English or you don't know English, start speaking. I think you have to start. You should speak to someone, and then only you can suppose. And see, there is one thing I have noticed in everyone those who want to learn English. They want to be fluent in one day. It is not going to happen, and it is not like it's like I am giving you a tablet of English and you will eat, and after that you will start speaking. It is not going to happen. You have to give your time. That is one thing I noticed. And everybody wants to post something like in that language articulation group. Like they are like copying from Google. They are not there. Means the words they have shared and they are not theirs. Like these words are not, they don't actually think in that way. So I think people don't share actually what is their level of English. So that is one thing. So I think instead of looking for perfection, you have to first accept that, okay, my English is bad. Now what to do? My English is bad. I should be honest to myself first thing. Okay, my English is bad. I need time. Because my English is in the initial stage, I need 1 hour per day. After that, I will reduce it. So I think that is the one thing people should accept that, okay, my English, people don't accept that. But they don't want to accept that, okay, how can somebody write better than me? Yes, he can write. He's practicing that. He can speak better than you because he is practicing that. So first you should accept that, okay, my English is bad. Then next level is now after accepting, then you have to how to improve my language, which is very important. That because if you don't want to be improved, and I think the criticism should be very positive. Suppose you are speaking to someone who's criticizing you, so you don't take it to the heart. But if it is a positive criticism, like somebody is telling you that you are making mistakes and you have to improve it, and then other criticism is like you can't do it, it's not your cup of tea, it's like that. So I think the positive criticism is should always be we all need positive criticism, and we should criticize every like the person who's we are talking in a positive way so that he can learn. And okay, so now I think we have talked enough. And I hope like your story and whatever the things you have shared that can help our viewers. And we will come back with another member. Okay. So bye. Take care. Shakti.
Okay. Thank you so much for asking me questions. And I really wish this group a very good future because it's really helpful for many, many beginners and many intermediate also. It's
still helping.
So, I wish good luck. And I'm so happy to be a part of this group also. Okay. Thanks for all the members and the founder. Okay. Bye.